Hi guys, how's it going? So today's topic is all about privacy in virtual reality, specifically with Facebook in hot water again, this time with WhatsApp. What does it mean for the future of VR and specifically perhaps with the Oculus Quest? Let's dive in. Welcome, by the way, to VR Essentials, where we talk about the practical uses of virtual reality and where you can get your weekly dose of VR educational entertainment. If you're new to the channel, very nice to meet you. And a huge welcome back, of course, to all our regular subscribers. Really awesome to have you with us again today. So today's topic, as I mentioned, is all about privacy in virtual reality and also with Facebook's latest story with a leak of WhatsApp, which apparently has been sharing our data since as early as 2016. The first story came out a few days ago in Wired.com, and since then, apparently only about 10 or 16 hours ago, Turkey have decided to actually take them to court for antitrust breach. WhatsApp, which is used by a lot of companies because it was actually deemed as an extremely safe place to be able to communicate amongst each other, not just on a personal level, but professional level, where we really believe that our data was really safe and secure. But it turns out that since 2016, Facebook have actually been using that data to record a variety of different things. And if you don't know about this story, you're going to be pretty shocked as to what they've been sharing with Facebook and potentially advertisers as well. Apparently, as well as very basic mundane things, for example, your battery life, or for example, the operating system that you're using, it is apparently said that they've been sharing the data of, for example, your IP address. But wait, they've also been sharing your actual logs, which basically means any conversation that you may have had or that you're having currently on a daily basis with your fellow professional colleagues or your friends or your family. Now, we've been sharing on the channel various different videos in relation to this topic, but I really feel that the area of education that's really lacking here is not so much having your data shared with potential advertisers or third parties so that they can advertise or send you advertisements in a way that is more relevant to you. It's really down to subliminal messaging to potentially change the way you think or make you act on something without you even potentially knowing it. But what does this really mean in relation to virtual reality and the impact that this is going to have on the future of VR in terms of our privacy? Facebook Reality Labs director recently released some notes as to their focus for the year of 2021, and they really want to push forward more options for us as to how we can control our privacy using any Oculus device. But looking back at the history of Facebook as to how they handle privacy, it really basically means that they're giving us the options to opt out of certain services within the platform, but it doesn't necessarily mean that these services are switched off within the actual database itself of the Facebook or Oculus devices, which basically means they can still get hold of that information and share it potentially, giving us the illusion that we're in control. Also, there was another very interesting article that came out very recently in regards to what Facebook's plans really are for us when we use one of the Oculus devices. Now, you need to know that it's been revealed that they can get hold of 20 million data points of any user in VR every 20 minutes. 20 million data points of any user in VR every 20 minutes. Now, this doesn't just mean data points of the user inside of virtual reality using a specific app, but also being able to track any data outside of the actual VR headset itself. This is because, as we have mentioned on this channel time and time again through various different videos, there are cameras now and also the microphone. It can hear our conversations. It can pick up anything around. So not just is it going to pick up, you know, your facial expressions, of course, because as VR is going to get more and more elaborate and technology is going to advance, it's going to be able to pick up, of course, your eye movements, your mouth movements, your breathing patterns, the way your muscles work at a macro level or so, but as well as analyze any items or objects around inside your house and also other people who may be nearby whilst you're in VR as well. Now, since this story has come out, and also, by the way, Facebook will be changing apparently their terms and conditions in February this year, where they can share even more data from WhatsApp. Now, Turkey is actually taking them to court now for antitrust breaches. Now, this adds more fuel to the fire because basically Facebook are now being sued by 48 different attorney generals in the United States from all different states. I mean, 48 states, that's pretty a lot. They're also being sued by the European Union and also Australia for both antitrust and anti-competitive laws. There's no conspiracy theory here. There's no, you know, aliens landing on Earth, Area 51. This is not what it's about. This is reality. The reality is that all these data points can really be used, and this has been proven through the past. By the way, this is not a machination coming from our imagination. It's the fact that basically these data points can be used to really dramatically change the impact on society itself. If we look at things, for example, Cambridge Analytica or the Brexit or the US elections, well, basically what these data points can do is really implant thoughts into our brains and make us do actions before we do them, which means it can really also impact, for example, the stock markets, you know, the housing market. It could impact elections across the world. It can also impact how you live your daily life in terms of what you eat, what you consume, all these kind of things. So it's really, really important to really pay attention to these kind of things. And even though it's great that, of course, Facebook are providing the Oculus Quest so cheap because it enables everyone to experience VR at an early stage, but at the same time, we also need to understand that our data, your data, is being used in a way that eventually this will come out in the future, maybe not next year, maybe not in 2 years, but it will come out eventually where there will be a story breaking in the newspaper where Facebook has been sharing your VR data potentially with third parties as well. So let's just be cautious, but in the meantime, of course, enjoy your time in VR.